morning guys, nice to see you all. Amanda here again at the booth centre. We're still not open I'm afraid, but remember we've got our emergency advice and support sessions in the garden Monday to Friday 9 till 12, so do come along if you've got any emergency, or pick up the phone when we call you, or reply to the text messaging service, and remember you can send those texts for free, and take part in the activities through our activities pack. We've got loads of exciting activities for you to do this week, so have a go, and Tom's going to inspire you now with some suggestions of how you can get involved with that. Remember, we've got the competitions as well, so you've got your chance of winning some money too. So hope to see you all soon when we reopen. Bye for now.
Thank you very much, Amanda, and cheers for the lovely welcome. And yes, welcome everybody else, ladies, gentlemen. Everybody else, wherever you find yourself on the gender spectrum, welcome to another Connecting Through Activities. We are up to, every time I say we're up to number something, I'm confused because we messed up one week and we put the wrong date on. So I don't even know if we're up to date or not. But I'm just going to go with what it says on the sheet. I feel like we're on 7, but this says 6. Anyway, so welcome to week 6, and the theme this week for our art and activities pack is Bird Week. So we're going to see birds, we're going to be touching and talking about a lot of different topics, bird stuff. I usually do some art, don't I? I can tell you now, I have been out again with my camera trying to find some birds, because one of the pages, let's have a look, page 6 in our booklet is a little bird searching section. So I did one last week, started one myself. I think I'm just great minds, isn't it, at the booth centre? I think it, start doing it, and then all of a sudden somebody's got like an official way of doing it. I was like, boom. All right, that works well. So yeah, birds for now. We've got this bird check sheet to get through. Got some art to do, like I said. We've got some poetry, but today it's from Phil, from Arthur and Martha. So for the last few weeks, we've had Danny doing it for us, haven't we? And he's been getting all creative and poetic and teaching us and showing us some good and inspirational ideas for poetry. So this week we've got Phil, who actually runs the sessions. So he's done a couple of videos for us, so I will be showing you those at some point, getting the creative juices going, trying to get everybody writing, staying busy whilst we're all still locked in, because yes, we have been given a little bit more freedom, we're allowed out a little bit more. We've still got to stay in all the time, haven't we? Still loads of people working from home, still loads of places that aren't even open, so lots of people just sitting at home like everybody else, just sitting there doing nothing, aren't we? So I'm here today and the rest of the week to guide us through some fun activities and hints and tips, etc. Alright, so I'm going to move into our art bit first, and you know how I like to do. I like to do a time lapse and show you what I have been doing myself. So, quick, you ready for a quick glance before I show you the time lapse? Boom! Oh, you bet you saw some bright colours there, didn't you? So, as you bet you know from that little glimpse, I've done some watercolours again. Last few weeks I've been trying it out. I had my first successful one last week, I think. I've not always been great at doing it, but last week I painted the booth centre garden and I was really happy with it. So I thought, you know what, let's do it again. It's Bird Week. Right, so I went through and I was like, what is dead colourful bird? What bird should I draw? Because the theme is just birds, it's not British birds, it's not anything specific like that. So I went for very bright and colourful one. Hummingbird, there you go. How beautiful is that? Bright greens, reds, pinks, purples, bit of orange down on his bum and stuff like that. Yellow's definitely in there. And then, yeah, lots of other shading and things like that. So I thought, you know what? It'll be nice to get a mix of all the colours, because they all blend, don't they? And watercolours are really good at blending. Not like felt tips, not like pencils, where it's just like colour, one colour, and then boom, they meet each other. With watercolours, they all merge together, especially if you use enough water. Not too much, you just got to use enough. It sounds like bloody bike commercial from Mars are going past my stupid neighbours on the motorbikes. So yeah, watercolours, amazing at mixing together. So let's have a look. I'll start a time lapse and you can see what I did. Start at the top. So yeah, I just did a pencil outline, and all I did was just copied that hummingbird that I just showed you a moment ago. I just copied, visually copied. I didn't trace it or anything. Almost went off the bottom of the page. I'm never that good at that. I start dead like, oh yeah, I've got loads of room for this. but then it didn't turn out. I had loads of room. So you know what I did there to make it look like I did it all intentionally? I stretched his beak out so it met the other side almost. So it made it look like I completely filled the whole page. And so here, what I'm doing, as you can see, is I'm just wetting all of the pastels. The watercolour, sorry. And then you go back in and I just watered the page. So that's why when I dropped that yellow colour on there, it like spread around and bleeded into each other. Obviously this is speeded up, so it's gonna be changing colours faster than I could probably talk, but added a bit of blue. And so yeah, so I followed the blue along its wing line, really strong, sharp line on the wing, isn't it? And then washed it out with water. So it got lighter and lighter away from the wing edge. That dark blue that I put on top there, that's the far away wing. That's the back of his left wing. I wanted to make sure there's a contrast between the two. So later on, I will go back and highlight that outer edge of the wing so you can see it a bit better. But yeah, all I'm really doing is just choosing colours that I like the look of, putting some along the edges, so like that green on the back of his neck sort of highlights the angle in his neck, and then a few underneath on the bottom of his belly. It's a bit darker under there, isn't it? Because less sun gets down there. I dry it off here because I'm very impatient. That's all. You don't need to dry yours with a hairdryer. I'm just impatient and I wanted to get my details in. So here, I've sort of done all the wishy-washy stuff. So I've blended together nicely, hasn't it? Now here, I've gone back with a little bit more concentrated paint and I'm just putting in some extra detail. So you see those stripes on the wings. Now, fine line under his belly. I thought I also put too much blue on the middle of his belly and then just washed it out with some more water. You could just put a touch more water on it and it will blend it out. I did a little white ring around the outside of his eye. That was the first time I've used the white, and then there we go, that's what I was telling you about. I did the white line down the back of his wing, didn't I, to separate those two wings. There you go, little zoom in for you. I was dead happy with that. I think I'm getting slightly better at watercolours, guys. I hope that you are too. The only way you can do it though is by trying, isn't it? So yeah, here it is in real life. Maybe I could add some more to it. What do you think? There's a lot of space here around here. There's other people I saw, they were doing that sort of like, you know, tapping their brushes over the top of it. So it's giving a nice splatter effect. Especially when it's got a wet, when you've got a wet-ish piece of paper, you do that splatter effect. Like the ball or droplet of paint lands and then spreads across the page into all of the water. So I'm proper loving that. I'm into watercolours now, officially. Tom's into watercolours. Right, moving on from the watercolour art section. Right, okay, so yes, I've got a sort of like a dual back-to-back video here from Richard. It's the end of one section of riddles that I did, but we didn't work it out, so it was a full one. So I've just taken the beginning of the next section and smashed it into the back of the old section. So part two and part three coming up now. You'll understand it when you watch it.
Riddle time again. So yesterday's riddle was, what word is spelt wrong in every dictionary? The word wrong. Okay, so today's riddle is, what two things can you never eat for breakfast? Have a think about that one.
What two things you can't eat for breakfast? Don't know about that one. Leave that with you guys. Does anybody at home have any clue of what it could be? Well, yeah, I'm not, nothing from me. But yeah, what was the other one? Oh yeah, wrong is spelt wrong in every dictionary. Of course it is. He didn't mean something was spelt incorrectly. He meant something, well, wrong is spelt wrong in every dictionary. There you go. Smart. Ah well, lovely. Right, moving over. Where are we gonna go now? Let's move over to a bit more bird activity, I think. Let's go and do the bird. What's it called? Bird spotting. I keep thinking like bird looking and things like that. It's not it. It's called bird spotting. So yeah, let's go and see what I managed to get hold of. So you may remember from last week, I had this. I'll quick show you on the screen. You can see some red circles on there. And there's also a little mini list there of other ones that I that I found when I was out that aren't on this list. So it turns out that a list of booth centre I've got us is a little bit shorter. So if I'd taken this out last week, we'd be in a much more successful position right now, because let's have a look at this. Let me compare notes. So Goldfinch on the new one, we got. Blackbird, we got. Nightingale didn't get. Blue Tit, we got. Starling, we got. Wood Pigeon, got. Robin, we got. And Magpie, we got. So we got 6 out of 7 of them last week. We only didn't get a Nightingale. So I went out today and I thought, I could top that. I can go out and get them all. All I need to do is find a Nightingale. But I wanted to start again, obviously. I'm not, it's a new week. I'm not gonna cheat and use my last photographs from last week. I'll get some fresh ones. So went out with my camera and the doggo, and we had a dig around the local area looking for some birds. So, right, let me have a look. I'm gonna have to zoom in on this because I can't see them. I'll zoom in for you as well, lovely. Oh, numero uno. I think we're going straight in there. He is either, so because there's only one, there's only blue tit on this, there's only one type of tit on the booth centre one. So am I going to say it's blue or great? I'm going to say that one's a great tit. So don't think that one is on our list. Yes, he's got the stripes on his wings. If you look at his second picture, he's got, yeah, he's got that stripy V's on his wing. And it's more black on his head, and like blue tits probably blue on the very skull cap of the head, aren't they? Whereas like coal tits, and yeah, the black is around his eye, but a blue tit is just a stripe of black around his eye. Whereas that comes up and over his head, doesn't it? Let's see if another picture. Another picture there, yeah, you can sort of see, you can see his beak at the front there. So going in, the white goes under his eye, doesn't it? And it doesn't do that on a blue tit. So fortunately, that's not one, Tom. Next, oh, the zooming speed motion. Can I find this one? Oh yeah, I remember this one. This guy, he was moving very fast. I thought he was the only one I was gonna catch, but no, that's a magpie. So think we might have our first one off the list. Get a big old green pen from our felt tips. I'm gonna give it a, I'll just give magpie a tick. There we go, so we've knocked one off the list already. How good's that? We're gonna find, we'll probably, like, with this list, I think we're probably gonna find more birds than they're on the list, this list, if you know what I mean. I'm gonna go out again, because I'll tell you now, I didn't get them all. It wasn't as successful as the last time. Last week, we got 6 out of 7. Let's keep counting and see what I managed to get this time, because it wasn't as good. I went out the same length of time. I went at roughly the same time of day. The only thing I could think of was like maybe a bit windier or less windier or something like that. I don't know. But anyway, next bird that I got a shot of. This one, action shot. Look at this guy flying. He was a beast. I love these. It's a crow, isn't it? What we're going to say, a carrion crow is what we what they're known as. Big, shiny black beak. You can see there, shining, like reflect that white on his arm, on his wing even. It's probably just like reflection of the sun. There we go, another one. Big old beauty. That's a good shot, isn't it? Big shiny black beak. Next one, what have we got here? Okay, oh, it's just another one of those silhouette ones. I think at the time, I think I was looking at like a robin maybe, or something a bit chubbier. What's a bit chubbier? Could be, it's either a robin or one of, some sort of tit, great tit, cold tit, blue tit, one of them. But yeah, I couldn't get a good shot, so not included. So yeah, obviously the crow is not on this list, so either. So, and now this cold tit is not on the list either. Right, here he is. I was like, oh, look, it's yellow beak. It's a blackbird. No, it's the same. It's a carrion crow. If you look at it from this angle, he's just got something in his mouth. I thought it was a blackbird, but no, it's a crow with probably a Mackie D's chips in his mouth or something like that. So still not ticked off another one. Right, let's move over. So this was a bit of a long shot, look at that. Miles away for this one, but you know what it is? It's a wood pigeon. And look at the picture here on the screen, and look at the picture on your sheet, and you can see, it's not just a regular pigeon. like those common ones that you see in town are different. I think like they're called a European or something like that, and they're obviously slightly smaller than these. They're not as fluffy. They don't keep themselves as well. I don't know if it's just they don't look after themselves or what, but they're probably just because they hang out in the city a bit more. But yeah, they're a lot smaller and they breed faster than these guys. These wood pigeons are a little bit more bigger and they don't breed as fast and they're not as common. So they are harder to find. Not all pigeons are wood pigeons. There you go. Little fact from you. Next one up, we've got... Oh yes, I was just running out. I was like, there's got to be a bird around here somewhere. But then all of a sudden a squirrel popped up. I was like, that'll do. That'll do. It's not on my list, but it's wildlife, innit? And then anyway, next shot, I was like, oh, he's got a magpie friend. Magpie's on the list. Oh, he got it. Damn, I was frustrated. By this point, I got like 4 or 5 on my other walk. But this one, nope. Next. Nope, there, another one of the squirrels sitting up, having a chew on his nuts. Right, here we go. And then walking home, I was like, yes. Well, I did at first think, it better not be that crow with something in his mouth, but it wasn't. And if you zoom in a bit, you can see it's a blackbird and he was singing. You could hear him from miles away. Oh, what? Oh, yes, it is. I nearly thought it wasn't on a list then. No, blackbird is on the list. He's number 2 on the list. So we've got 3 so far. Not terrible, not terrible. What else is there? Did I get anything else? Let's skip over next. So, singing blackbird. Ah, yes, here we go. You can tell by how shiny these boys are that these are starlings, aren't they? They have like the speckled, when you look up close, they've got like quite speckled, but look at them at a distance like that, especially on a sunny day. They have like the pearlescent, almost oily look to them, don't they? Very sharp, dark black, but the brownish when you get up to them, and yeah, like greeny purples in them somewhere. So starling, boom, we are getting through. It wasn't as bad as I thought. And then last one, what else did we have here? One more. Ah, yeah, a little sparrow with a mouthful of feathers so we can go, that's a little girl, that one. So she can go and make a nest. Probably not for laying eggs, because I think that's been, unless they have a double season, unless they have 2 egg seasons. Some smaller birds like that do. They can flip over the rate of egg production pretty fast. Some birds only do it once a year. Some birds can do it a few times a year. Well, obviously chickens, they can just constantly do it, can't they? But I think that's probably because we've bred them to be that way. But some birds naturally do it twice in a year, don't they? There you go. So yeah, that was a sparrow. I thought I was pretty successful, other than the fact that sparrow's not on the booth centre list, so I can't even tick it off. So, we've not got a goldfinch, we've not got a nightingale, we've not got a blue tit, we've not got robin. Well, I suppose only last time we only got... No, we did, yeah, we got 3 more last time. So we got goldfinch, blue tit and robin last time. So we've still got, yeah, goldfinch, blue tit, robin and nightingale to get, so... I don't know if I've ever, never seen a nightingale, but I don't think they're that popular around where around my neck of the woods. So I might have to go literally into the woods. Yeah, there's a few areas I could go into, like a few streams and things like that, which have got some wood covering. Hopefully I could go down there. Maybe I should look at just general wildlife down there, see if I can find anything else other than birds down there. Insects, etc., mammals. Whatever else is out there. Cool, right, well that's a start on that. Anyway, we've got 4 out of 7, I think 7, 8, 4 out of 8. So we're halfway there already, banging. Right, pass that one back over there and we can move on to the next section, which will be our poetry section. So yes, we have Arthur and Martha at the centre. They do our creative writing, don't they? And they have been helping Danny along with Phil to write some poems, well, theme the poems is what they've been doing. Danny's been writing them, but Arthur and Martha, Phil from Arthur and Martha has been theming them for everybody anyway. So, right, I'm not going to read it. It is in our activity packs, next to his little picture there, our Phil. Can you see that? See, will the page focus? No, it still focuses on me. That's always the thing. If my face is in camera, it will focus on me rather than the sheet. Modern technology, you think it's good, and now it's just really dark. Come on, brighten up. There we go. See, it does what it's told, doesn't it? Sometimes. Right, okay, so yes, I was talking about art, poetry corner, wasn't I? So, I'm just going to jump into it. Phil has made us a really nice, relaxing, chilling video where he goes through suggestion one on the art, well, poetry section. So yeah, over to Phil.
This is Phil here from Arthur and Martha. Although, of course, this is not Phil that you're actually seeing right now. It's my cat, Purdy. And she's there to be inspiration for you, because I would like you to write 8 lines about an animal or a bird or some form of life that is not human that you have seen today or in the last couple of days, something that sticks in your mind. And I would like you to revisit it and conjure it up in your imagination. And I would like you to write only 8 lines, just 8 lines. And for a bit of extra inspiration, I'm going to read you a poem by Ted Hughes. And he imagines in this the visit of a fox. The poem is called The Thought Fox. I'm going to read you 8 lines from it. Cold. Delicately as the dark snow, a fox's nose touches twig, leaf. 2 eyes, a movement that now and again, now and again, and now, across clearings, an eye, a widening, deepening green, brilliantly, concentratedly, coming about its business. So there you go. 8 lines from Ted Hughes and my cat.
That was so bloody relaxing. I don't know if I'm just getting into poetry or something now, but I just like the lowness of his voice and the delivery of his words. Come on, focus camera, please. There we almost got me, hasn't it? Yeah, I'm just loving poetry. Yes. Sorry about this, folks. It's not focusing properly. Maybe it's the softness of the voice. It's going into soft focus. I don't know. Anyway, lovely. Yeah, we're going to have a little bit more from Phil later on in a week. I will probably have a go, as I have been doing. The idea is, what my theory is if I can do it, you can do it. I'm no different. I'm just sitting here, bored at home like you are. We've all got pens now. I've got a couple of pencils even. Get it scribbled. It's just creative, isn't it? It doesn't matter. There's no right and wrong. Nobody's saying it's good or bad. If you like the sound of it, then that's all that matters. And if it reminds you or something like that of something or somewhere else, then it's poetry. Then it's what is worth. It's worth its weight in gold, isn't it? If to the individual. Right, sweet. Anyway, next up, I think we should go over to the music section. I've got 2 bangers for you. What we've got? We've got Rolling Stones and a little bit of Lou Reed. What should we go for? So we've got Sympathy for the Devil by Rolling Stones and Perfect Day by Lou Reed. We'll go Perfect Day first and build up Sympathy for the Devil. So here we go. A gentleman with his daughter dancing in the background of this one, so that's a nice little touch. Just get my headphones set up properly. Better, isn't it? Well, for me anyway.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we'll go home. Just a perfect day. Feed animals in the zoo. And then later, a movie too, and then home. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep me hanging on. Just a perfect day. Problems all left alone. Weekenders on our own. It's such fun. Just a perfect day. You made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else, someone good. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep me hanging on. You're going to reap just what you sow. You're going to reap just what you sow. You're going to reap just what you sow. You're going to reap just what you sow.
Amazing, amazing. And this little girl just having a dance there in the background. She's alright, gotta be a ballerina, by the looks of it. Okay, so from something as lovely as Perfect Day by Lou Reed, let's go over, straight jump in, Sympathy for the Devil by Rolling Stones.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. So many men sold their faith. And I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made them sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his fate. Pleased to meet you. I hope you guess my name. Oh, what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. I stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was time for a change. I killed the Tsar and his ministers. Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held the general rank. When the blitzkrieg raged and the body stank. Pleased to meet you. Pleased to meet you. I hope you guess my name. I was puzzling you with the nature of my game. Watching glee, watching kings and queens for pretender games. But I got the god made. I shouted out who killed the Kennedys. When after all it was you and me. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. Lay traps for the troubadours who got killed before they reached Bombay. Pleased to meet you. I hope you get my name. I was puzzling you with the nature of my game.
Confused me a bit towards the end, but I loved it. No, my, and again, another epic tune there. Lovely stuff. All great tunes from the Booth Centre Songbook, all selected by the visitors of the centre, by obviously wise young ladies and gentlemen, aren't they? Good taste in music, anyway. So yeah, I should start wrapping that one up, I think, for today. We've had our art, we've had our riddle from Richard, we've had my little bird, I keep forgetting what it's called, bird spotting, didn't I? And, oh yeah, sorry, I forgot. With the art, obviously, there's a tenner, isn't there? Every week we're giving away £10 to whoever gets nominated by the people, volunteers and the staff at the centre. They'll have a look through, decide which one they like the best. And so the best bird art, or the best answer, well, it's not the best answer, the one with correct answer, you could be in with winning a tenner. I think the question is, oh yeah, the question is, if you don't want to draw a picture and you just want to put the answer in and a nice note to go along it, that would be good. What birds cannot fly? There's a few that you could use as an answer for that. So get it scribbled on, get it sent in, write us a nice note or something like that, because we love receiving them. There's also, if you write a poem on it, Danny can assess it, you may even win a £10 from that, so it's all worth doing, isn't it? Anyway, right, I'm going to wrap it up like I said now, so yeah, my annoying neighbours with the motorbikes back, so you probably can hear it anyway. So, I shall see you all later, stay safe, stay indoors, wash your hands. I've been Tom.